use the Oracle Autonomous Transaction Processing Console to create an instance and create a user. You can start from the cloud.oracle.com homepage. Click Sign In. On the Cloud Account page, enter the cloud account name that you received from your welcome email or your cloud administrator. Click My Services. Enter your username and password. Click Sign In. If you see the Set Preferences page, enter your language and time zone and click OK. On the Cloud My Services page, click the navigation menu in the upper corner to show top-level navigation choices. Click Services to show the available services. Scroll down the list of available services and select Autonomous Database from the list. On the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure page, click the menu in the upper corner to show the available services. From the navigation pane, click Autonomous Transaction Processing. The console for Autonomous Transaction Processing appears. You can use the List Scope drop-down menu to select a compartment. In this example, the Dock compartment is selected. Although this console shows that no databases have yet been created, if there were a long list of databases, you could filter the list by using the Filters drop-down menu to filter the state of the database, available, stopped, terminated, and so on. Click Create Autonomous Transaction Processing. The Create Autonomous Transaction Processing dialog appears. At the top of the dialog, click the Click Here link to select a compartment for the database. Select a compartment for the database from the drop-down list. In the Create Autonomous Transaction Processing dialog, enter a database display name for display purposes. Enter the database name. Specify the number of CPUs for your service. Select your storage capacity in terabytes, and specify an administrator password for the admin user of the service instance. For license type, select whether you are using an included license or bringing your own license. Click Create Autonomous Transaction Processing. The Create Autonomous Transaction Processing dialog closes. On the console, the state field indicates that the database is provisioning. When creation is completed, the state field changes from provisioning to available. Once you have created the instance, download the credentials zip file for client access to that instance. From the main console, click Service Console. A dialog opens to sign in to the Service Console. In the Username field, enter Admin, the default administrative user that was created for your Autonomous Transaction Processing account. In the Password field, enter the administrator password you specified when you created your service instance. The Service Console opens in the Overview mode. Click Administration to switch to the Administration mode. Download a zip file containing the security credentials and network configuration files to access your instance. You're prompted to create a password for the credentials zip file. Enter a password and click Download to download the file. Store the file and make note of the password. You will use the file and password later to define a SQL developer connection to your Autonomous Transaction Processing database. Now you can define a SQL developer connection to the database in your Autonomous Transaction Processing service. Click New Connection to open SQL Developer and define a connection. Specify a connection name. Enter the database username, using the default administrator database account, admin, that is provided as part of the service. Enter the admin user's password that you or your cloud administrator specified when creating the service instance. For connection type, select Cloud PDB. For the configuration file, click Browse, and select the client credentials zip file. And if you're using a version of SQL Developer older than 18.2, there is a KeyStore password field for entering the client credentials zip file password. For the service, select low, medium, or high. These service levels map to the low, medium, and high consumer groups, which provide different levels of performance and concurrency. Click Connect to connect to your database. Once you have connected SQL Developer to your Autonomous Transaction Processing database, use a SQL Developer worksheet to define database users. Autonomous Transaction Processing databases come with a predefined database role named DW role. This role provides the common privileges for a database user. For detailed steps on performing the example shown in this video, go to the Oracle Learning Library and open the tutorial named Provisioning Autonomous Transaction Processing. Learn more at cloud.oracle.com/ATP.